Okay, Sachin, we have someone really special now joining us, Dr. Madhav Chavan, who's one of the real pioneers in the field of education. He's the founder of Pratham. He's the winner of the Wise Award, which is the equivalent, I would have to say, of the Nobel Prize in the field of education. Dr. Chavan, it's a privilege to have you with us. You have, of course, been conducting these great studies and surveys on the state of education in the country. Perhaps you could just sum up for us what some of the results are. Are we on the right track, or are we going in reverse gear in this country?
We are on the right track in getting all the children in schools. We are now more than 96% children enrolled in schools all over India. But as far as the learning in the schools is concerned, I'm afraid for the last couple of years we've seen declining trends in the learning levels of children, which means that our schools are getting defocused from the basic learning of reading, writing, arithmetic. On other counts, especially what you are trying to do, giving schools basic facilities and so on, I think what we've observed is that the facilities such as drinking water, usable toilets, that those indicators are climbing gradually upwards. That is something that the governments have been focusing on as well. So I think it's a mixed bag. We do feel that learning levels have to go higher and something needs to be done about it.
You know, if I could just look at some of the statistics that I'm seeing, first of all, about the quality of education that you were talking about, I was struck by the fact that in some states like Tamil Nadu, 0 to 10% of class 5 students can read class 2 text. Is that really correct? Because that sounds rather frightening to me. In other states, it's better. Himachal Pradesh, it's something like 61 to 70%. But it means there's a wide variation between states on how, what the quality of education that the children are getting.
Yes, there is a wide variation. We have asked ourselves this question as to why this should happen. There are multiple reasons. For example, when we first started this measurement, people were struck by the fact that more children in Bihar could read standard level, the standard 2 level than in Tamil Nadu. What we found was that if you separated the proportion of children who are in school in Bihar into those who go to private tutors, which is now about 48% in the primary grades, then they are reading much more fluently and many more of them are reading than the children who are not going to tutors. In Tamil Nadu, the proportion of children who go to tutors is much smaller. So this is one probable example that getting home support is important. Something outside the school is also important. This is one. In Tamil Nadu, it's really something that we do not understand why the proportion of children who can read or do arithmetic is low. One factor in Tamil Nadu could also be that in Tamil Nadu, there's a lot of urbanization, and the proportion of children going to private schools, urban and rural put together, is nearly about 68%. What that means is children who go to government schools are a very, very small proportion, and only the poorest, who absolutely have no home support, are going to government schools.
Okay.
Now, these are possible reasons that we could cite, but I think, I'm sure there are more deeper reasons why this is happening.
Well, Dr. Chavan, one of the things that I think Sachin and I were drawing some heart from a little earlier in the day, coming from your report, one of the specific issues that we've been trying to highlight under the Support My School campaign is the question of toilets, and specifically separate toilets for girl children, which we thought was one of the major reasons why girls are dropping out in the number that we are. Now, I was quite pleased to see in the AISA report that the numbers seem to have gone up very sharply in the proportion of schools that actually have separate toilets for girls. It's still not adequate. It's still not anywhere what it should be, but it's gone up sharply between 2010 and 2012. So somewhere do you think the message is going home? And perhaps the awareness campaign is also helping.
I'm sure. Once there is focus, things start happening. I suppose you are adding to that focus. And the governments are also trying to do that. But I think this is something that can be achieved quickly and around the country, and it should be done. There is no reason why it should not be done.
Okay, okay, Dr. Chavan. Sachin, anything you want to add, anything you want to say to Dr. Chavan?
No, I feel, from your earlier statement, you said we are on the right track. But just another message to everyone that even if you are on the right track, you still got to keep moving, otherwise the trainer is going to come and hit us. Yeah. We want to continue to progress. We want to continue getting better. And I think this is one challenge which is going to require a mega effort for everyone to smile eventually. And that is the idea. You know, there are many kids sitting here in front of me. They all are smiling, and similarly I want to see children smiling in rural areas as well.
Right, that message will of course go through. Dr. Chavan, thank you so much for joining us. Any final thoughts you want to leave us with?
Thank you, and thank you, Sachin, for joining us all in this.